Hello, my friends, and welcome back to our children's Bible story. This one, of course, is our series, Biblical Wise Wisdom. Wisdom that if you learn how to work, will help you have good, peaceful, joy-filled lives with as few problems with other people as can happen. This is Pastor Mark of Clinton Avenue Reformed Church welcoming you back. Can you believe this is the last day of July already? This summer has gone by way too fast. I like my summers. I wish they could last forever, but they can't. So let's start. How do we start? You remember, we sing a little bit of our spirit song together. So please join me for that. I love this song. What a great song. I do like that. I hope you've grown to like it as well in all of these weeks. Are you ready for our little Bible passage today? I hope so. If you learn this, it will help you in your life. What good is it, my brothers and sisters, if someone claims to have faith but not have works? Surely that faith cannot save him, can it? If a brother or sister is lacking in clothing and daily food, one of you says to them, "Go in peace, keep warm, eat your fill," yet you do not supply their bodily needs, what is the good of that? So faith by itself, if it has no works, is dead. Well, what does that mean, my friends? You know, someone can say, you know, "I really love baseball," but they never watch a game. They never play baseball. They never go to a game. They never put the game on the radio or TV. You scratch your head and say, do they really like baseball? Suppose someone says, "I just love music." And you can't remember them ever listening to music or singing or even humming. You say, does that person really like music? Or are they just saying it for some reason? Now, suppose someone says to you, "I really, really have faith in God. I really want to live what God tells me to live," but then doesn't seem to care about someone who's really poor, doesn't seem to care about someone who's struggling and having troubles, not trying to be there for someone. Well, you have to wonder, are they really trying to live as God commands us to live? You have to ask that question. Suppose there's some kid that you know in a playground really looking upset, like he's had the worst day in the world. And you say, "Well, I feel bad for that kid. but don't go over and ask him if he's okay. Ask if there's some way you can help him. Well, do you really feel badly for that kid? Something to think about. Suppose you say you feel badly that someone's getting bullied at school. Say, oh, I feel so badly. But you don't go try to help. You don't try to stop a bully. You don't even like tell a teacher this kid's getting bullied by this kid. Well, do you really feel that badly about it? That's a question that we all need to answer. It's one thing to say we want to live this godly life and get God's peace and God's joy. We really want to live in a way that gets us a lot of friends and very few people who don't like us. But are we actually doing something about it? Now, it's no coincidence that the people who get the best grades are the ones who try the most and study the most. And often they say, I really want good grades, and they work at it. Now, suppose you say, I really want good grades, but never open a book, never do homework, never study. Do you really think you're going to get good grades? Seriously? Probably not. So if we want these good, peaceful lives, it's not enough to just say that we want to live like God tells us to live. We actually have to do it by being kind to others, being concerned if someone really doesn't have enough to eat, if their family doesn't earn enough income to survive. If someone doesn't have many friends or might be getting bullied, well, if we really want to celebrate God's love, if we really want to live like God wants us to live, we've got to do something about it. Don't just talk about it. Do it. And I know we all can. You folks care, or you wouldn't be watching this series. Thank you for listening on this hot July day. Please, if you're watching this on Facebook, like it, share it, comment it on it, invite some friends. I'm not going to be happy until every kid in the whole world is watching this. Ready to sing a little bit more with me? I hope you are. I like to hear you sing. It's always pleasing to me. I like that. Thank you for joining in with me. Now, you know how we always finish this up, right? I hope to see you next week. Until then, God bless you richly. And please, if you want wonderful lives that are full of friends, filled with peace and joy, and if you want that spirit to overcome every trouble, listen to this wisdom. Think about it. Just do it. This is Pastor Mark of Clinton Avenue Reformed Church, Bergenfield, New Jersey. God bless you.